Oh, let's just arrive in our space, hands down on our knees. I think everybody's got a lot going on these days. A lot happening in the collective. Just allow yourself a moment of grounding. Let's really visualize sending that taproot down through the mat, deep into the earth, breaking through into the soil. Your root meeting down with the roots of the trees and the grasses and the vines. Allowing it to really dive deep into that connection with the heart of Mother Earth. Feeling into the pull of gravity. Truly being aware of the weight and the density of the human body and that gravity tethering us to Earth. And as we kind of shift and move to find our alignment, sit bones down, allowing the belly to open up, rising up through the chest, rolling the shoulders up and back, relaxing down, releasing tension, and reaching the crown up towards the heavens as we engage Jalandhara Bandha lightly. Rolling the eyes up to the third eye point. And just bringing our awareness to our breath. Physical body, one body. Pranic body is another of the 10 yogic bodies. And breathing in and exhaling out any stale energy, starting to fill ourselves up consciously with fresh prana, allowing the breath of life to shift and undulate through all parts of our being, through the energy centers, deep into the bloodstream, finding places of stale energy and just letting ourselves release anything that's old, anything that's heavy from the inside. And starting to come into awareness about how the body shifts and moves and undulates with the breath, and we expand and contract, and with that our auric field as well. The field around us expanding on the inhale, contracting on the exhale. And perhaps intentionally bringing it a little bit closer to you. This work we are doing is all about our own field, our own energy, not anyone else's, so we can clear it, activate it, and by the end really show up in our highest vibration, what's available for us today. And it doesn't have to be perfect. But let's try and make it strong and centered and clear. Bring the hands out in front of you and just start to rub the palms together, creating that warmth and that heat. Bringing that heat into the prayer pose, connecting at the heart center, thumbs at the sternum, fingers pointing up and out. Let's take a nice cleansing breath in through the nose. Great big sigh out. And before we tune in, just thinking about the words that we're chanting, this Om Namo Guru Dev Namo, this bowing to a higher consciousness, a greater wisdom, an opening up of our connection and flow by also bowing to the own wisdom we carry within, our Mangala Charn surrounding us with a protective light, calling on that vibration of protection. North, south, east, west. So let's take a deep inhale to begin. Om Namo Guru Dev Namo. Om Sat Gure Name, Sat Gure Name, Siri Gure Vename, Ad Gure Name, Jugad Gure Name, Sat Gure Name, Siri Gure Vename, Ad Gure Name. Jugad gure name, sat gure name, siri gure vename. Inhale, hold the breath. Opening up the heart, throat, third eye, crown. Connection and protection. Release the elbows down, open the lotus cup at your heart, and let's take a moment of silence, just connecting with the thoughts, the ideas, the to-dos, the worries, and the concerns, and just placing them in the cup one by one, letting the energy from the brain flow down into the heart. When the cup is full, let's take a deep inhale and give it up to God. Let those thoughts, let the worries and concerns be held. Turning the palms out on the exhale, very intentionally sweep through your field, clearing it of anything that's not yours. Your fingertips do touch the earth. Allow yourself to feel into that grounding as you simultaneously reach the crown up, connected above, connected below, heart at the center. Breathe deeply into your belly. Expand, take an extra sip through rounded lips, expand through the heart. Hold it, let your field be strong and vital around you. Release the breath with a great big sigh. Go ahead and bring your hands up, palms facing forward. Calm yourself and claim yourself. How to act and not react. As we find our posture, we inhale with a whistle through rounded lips and we let the tongue get involved. The tongue's out just a little bit. It's not a Satali breath. It's just we want to make sure the sides of the tongue get involved. We whistle in 4 or 5 seconds and we hold the breath. Make sure your mudra is strong, the thumb and index, the knowledge pressing down on the ego, the fingers reaching up towards the heavens. As we exhale, it's a great big cannon breath. Let it all go. Inhale. hold it. Continue at your own pace. Find your strength, find your center here, find your calm and peace. Anything you need to surrender that's unsettling you, let it go with that exhale. One more. The left hand come down onto the heart space, elbow out, keep the right hand up. Inhale deeply, hold it. Exhale all the way out through the nose. Hold it. We're holding it for 15 seconds. Inhale deeply all the way in, as much prana as you can get. Feel your chest rise beneath the palm. Hold. Exhale deeply all the way out. Hold. Inhale deeply all the way in. Hold. Exhale all the way out. We're doing it for 20 now. Hold. One more. Inhale. All the way. Hold. Exhale all the way out. Hold. Inhale, bring both hands to the heart. Let the elbows drop. Just breathe. Last little pranayama is for calmness of heart. Coming into that place of peace and connection, kindness and compassion for self, honoring your being, mind, body, and spirit. Nose, rise up through the chest. Hold it. Extra sip through rounded lips. Anything that's left that you need to release, great big sigh. Slowly come to standing. Find a posture where you feel really solid. Feet can be wider than hip width distance. We're just going to inhale left, exhale right. Everything today should be done at your pace. Things can be done extremely slow. It can be done faster depending on how you're feeling. The hand will touch the heart as you get to the full extension. Then it's released. Touch the heart again. Breath and the body together. Again, the rise and the fall of the chest with the moving physical form. Sat Nam. Plus 30 seconds, a little more movement, a little more twist. Center. Let's let our hands drop down by the sides. We're going to flip the right palm up. We're going to inhale. We're going to sweep over. Exhale, sweep the opposite way. And when you do this, let's start off slow so you can really feel the arm slide down and past the knee. Get that full arch. Like, let yourself have the full stretch. Then release it. Full breaths in, full breaths out. Inhaling to the left, exhaling to the right. You're sweeping your field at the same time that you're getting the stretch. The feet are solid on the earth. The legs are straight, no bend in the knees. Center. We're going to do miracle bends here. So inhaling up, back, and just try that once where you're really pushing the toes and the heels equally, opening up to the day, bending back as far as is comfortable. And then when we exhale, really being clear about coming forward, bending from the waist, dropping the fingers down, letting the head be heavy. Feel the stretch in the back of the legs. Let the full weight of the head drop down. Then we inhale back up. Go super slow to start. Get everything that you can out of this movement. Heads down, our arms dangling. If you can, take your hands and press them into the earth. If you can't, don't worry, just dangle as far as you can. If you can, actually go ahead and bend the knees to make sure your hands can touch. Feel the support beneath you. Feel that connection through the hands and the feet. Let's breathe in. Let's sigh out. back, exhale. Then righting yourself so you're standing tall and straight, arms up in a V. Inhale deeply. Reach, stretch, feel it through the armpits, feel it through the ribs. Push your feet into the earth as you reach towards the sky. And now pull Mula Bandha first time today. Pull up, pull in. You know exactly what you need to do. Pull up on the navel. Activate the Kundalini. Visualize it curling up, this beautiful light, helping you to break through blocks, getting us back into our most natural state of flow. Hold it. Really pull. Hold it. And release. Sweep your field. Land solid, those feet on the earth. Reach the crown higher as the hands go lower. Touch the thighs. Let the shoulders drop. Standing strong as this beautiful pillar of light. Deep inhale through the nose. Extra sip, rounded lips. Great big sigh out. Come on back down onto your mats. Feet together. Knees out. And working on releasing tension in the groin, the hips. So we interlace our fingers around our toes in a Venus lock. So if you need to tap into that feminine energy, left thumb on top, masculine right on top, and simply inhale up and exhale down. You want to make sure your sit bones are connected. Maybe bring your heart through your arms. Crown is up. Thank you.
path, belly and bandha. Cross the legs in a gentle, easy pose. Hands on the knees. Come into that beautiful, perfect alignment. And I want you to think about, we're going to do 15 rotations to the left and 15 to the right. We are not doing big circles. We are doing the lower lumbar through the sacrum, all about digestion, all about connecting the root to the earth, all about shifting and moving and starting to get into the sacral waters, allowing. It's a really beautiful for grounding sexual energy, grounding into the earth, but also activating that passion and creativity as well. So let's begin. Inhale forward, exhale back. 15 to the left. Done your 15, you stop for a moment in the center and do your 15 right. We'll all meet seated, just breathing from root to the crown. Excellent for working on the lower intestines. Digestion, that apana, that elimination. On bringing the prana down to the root, pulling it up, your prana, exhaling your apana, the life force up, the elimination down, rising and falling. Then bring your attention to your torso, this whole area of the sternum, 15 circles to the left and right, but you're really focused right here. So opening up the heart, front and back, trying to pull thank you. connected with a bit of fear. Take the hands down onto the ankles or just by them and really focus on the root. We're gonna rock. This is a spinal flex, but it's really a rocking of the lower chakra on the earth. Inhaling forward, exhaling back, rocking forward, making the spine, particularly the lower lumbar spine, really curvy. Exhale back. Now, if that's awakening the first and second chakras that root into the sacral waters, safety, security, passion, creativity, now come to the center, take a deep inhale down into your root and into the sacral waters. Hold the breath, squeeze Mula Bandha, push those knees down towards the earth. Pull up, pull in, hold. Let that Kundalini clear out anything that's heavy in that space. We want everything to be able to flow up into the fire and the air that is the solar plexus and the heart. Release, let go, apana. Bring your hands onto your knees. Focus on this third and fourth chakra, the fire of the navel, solar plexus, and the heart. Spinal flex with those. Bringing it into the thoracic. So working on that torso again. Really opening up back and forth. It's like you're opening up your angel wings on the back, opening up the heart forward. Courage to live from the heart space, that fire being fueled by the air. Let that green air energy just expand. Start to come back to the center. Find your place of peace. Deep inhale. Holding the breath, squeezing Mula Bandha, pulling up at the navel and the diaphragm, getting all of that energy right into the heart, that lower triangle, holding up the heart space. Hold it. Crown reaches even higher. Release. Go ahead and shift yourself into a rock pose if that's available. Otherwise, you can stay in easy pose. But the hands are going to go on to the knees. We bring our attention up here now to the cervical spine, the thoracic into the cervical. We're going to be bending the head back a little bit, arching forward, bringing the chin to the chest. Opening up through the throat chakra, receiving the back for the third eye. Upper thighs, crown is reaching high. Inhale, hold the breath, squeeze Mula Bandha. up and over, so the thumbs are on the back of the shoulders, the four fingers are on the front, upper arms parallel. Start an inhale left and exhale right, and really take your time. Get the full twist through the upper torso. Again, nothing needs to be jarring here. Your head is shifting and moving, so you're getting the twist through the cervical spine as well. Energy, waking up the upper triangle. This also helps to activate the arc line that goes from the ear to the ear. To the center, hold the posture, and then take your fingers back to where we started when we were doing that breath work. Thumb and index, Gyan Mudra, palms facing forward. And we're going to speed this up just a little bit here. Inhale left, exhale right. It's a little more free in the posture. You can move a little bit faster. Center, hold the posture, inhale, hold the breath, squeeze Mula Bandha. Receiving all of the knowledge, tapping into that field, rising up our Kundalini, hold, release. Come down onto the knees and just slowly inhale left, exhale right. Shoulders are rising. Shoulders drop and switch sides. Inhale right, exhale left. The shoulders, reach the crown up as high as you can. Jalandhara Bandha is engaged, and then tilt the chin down even more. Touch the chest, get the stretch through the back of the neck, and then start to rotate the head to the right shoulder, back at all of the kinks out, over to the left shoulder, and then down. Two more big circles. Done three, switch direction and do three in the opposite direction. Find your place of peace with your crown reaching up. Gentle Jalandhara Bandha engaged.
engage, so that when we do pull Mula Bandha here, we can really invite the Kundalini to rise from the root all the way up to the crown. Take a deep inhale. Hold it, squeeze Mula Bandha. Pull up and in with the navel. Gentle faces, maybe a little smile, bring it up. And as you're squeezing and holding, use your core to slowly start to rise up. Rise up with your energy and then slowly start to sweep the arms up into prayer. You're still squeezing, you're still holding. Release the breath in the bandha, but hold the posture. Take another deep inhale. Reach higher. Squeeze up and in. Becoming a beautiful pillar of light. On the exhale, we'll bow down towards the earth. Palms will touch. Come onto all fours. We find our center. And we just go into a cat-cow. Now shifting and moving, balancing all of the energy, using the pelvis as the lead. Go at the speed that feels right for you. Flat back now. Bring your big toes together. Bring your knees a little bit wider. Go ahead and come up into the cow, pushing the pelvis back, opening up through the throat chakra. Let's take, let go of the breath first, and then take a deep inhale in this posture. Hold it. Exhale, release into your cat, really dramatic, really get the stretch, and then release the breath as you drop back down. Buttocks go to the heels, drop the third eye, stretch. Let yourself just land here for a moment. Just breathe. Body has just been woken up from tip to toe, getting out all of the tension. Now we can really play with our energy. Take a nice long deep inhale. Hold the breath, squeeze Mula Bandha in this posture. Just visualize seeing all of the chakras lighting up from the root to the crown. Expanding and being open to receiving. The third eye is firmly connected to the earth. Release it. Slowly start to walk yourself up. You can kind of bring the legs through. I'm going to bend the knees and come down on our backs and then bring the knees up. Interlacing the hands over the shins. I'm just gonna rock up and back really gently. Again, shifting and moving all of that energy we've created. Just keep going. You've
got about 30 more seconds of just gently rocking, circulating energy through the entire spine. Yourself up, seated. Let your left leg come out straight. Let your right foot come into the groin. Wherever is comfortable for you, but get it as close as you can. You can rub for a second the under part of the knees and the upper part, just giving it a bit of a massage as we try and straighten that leg. Just giving it a little love. The left foot is going to be in a flexed posture. We're going to take a moment to come into alignment, inhaling up straight, exhaling, bending over that left leg. Now, if you can press into the big toe, that's fine. Otherwise, just pull it back or grab the ankle. But drop the head, drop the elbows, and begin a breath of fire. Just 30 seconds, pumping the navel. Up, hold the breath, squeeze Mula Bandha, take all of that beautiful energy you created with that breath of fire, raise it up, turn the palms out on the exhale, release the breath, the Bandha, sweep the field, fingertips touch and ground, and we switch legs. Left foot comes into the groin, right leg out and flexed, massaging the knees. Helping them to straighten, to be strong there. Then we inhale, rise up as high as you can so you can bend on the exhale from the waist. Grab the toes, drop the elbows, drop the head, breath of fire. Inhale, rise up. Reach, 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 reach. Push your sit bones down as you reach up through the crown, through the arms, stretching the armpits. Pull Mula Bandha. Exhale, sweep your field. As you do so, straighten that left leg out to meet the right. Both legs out in front. Both feet flexed. Ground through the earth. Turn the palms facing up, back of the hands on the earth. Inhale, sweep up into prayer. Hold it for a moment. And then exhale, flow down over the legs, grabbing the toes if you can, otherwise the ankles. If you could press into the big toe, then drop the head down for 1 minute. We inhale up. Exhale down while we're still holding the feet. Sorry, I should have made that clear. Down and up. Ten more seconds. drop the head down. Inhale. Press into the toes. Get the head as close as you can. Squeeze Mula Bandha. Pull the belly up and in. Hold. Then as you release, keep the eyes closed. Just slowly rise up. And then as you get to the top, tap into all of the strength of your core and let yourself release from the hips down. Let the lumbar spine start to connect. We're lying down flat on our backs, but go slow. Down through the thoracic, lay down the cervical spine, let the head drop. Release, take the hands under the buttocks. And very controlled, we just start to inhale, rise up. The legs 90 degrees, exhale down. Just slow and steady. Up and down. Inhale up, exhale down. Seconds. Have the legs up straight. And take the hands and grasp beneath the knees. Really pull them straight. Inhale. Hold the breath, squeeze Mula Bandha. Pull the navel back towards the mat. Hold your gazing up through the closed eyes, through the third eye point. As we exhale, we bend the knees. We place our feet pretty wide on the mat, let go. And then using your core, inhale as you press the feet in, inhale up, rise up, place your left hand on the top of the right elbow, left hand on the left, on the right hand on the left. Find your strength here. Slowly exhale down until you really feel it in your core, then rise up, exhale down. Rise up, exhale down, rise up, continue. See how low you can get, how engaged your core can become before the feet lift up. Press down in those feet so you could really feel it. Roll back. Total control. You've got this. You are so strong.
hands underneath the buttocks. We're going into stretch pose for a minute. Sorry, and you can also, if you are strong enough, you can have your hands out like this for stretch pose. The feet come up 12 inches, the head. For my lower back, I like to have my hands underneath my buttocks. If it's too much, do 1 foot at a time. Let's go ahead. Let me get us a little more lively. We always need a little inspiration for a stretch pose, right? Okay, this 1 minute, the head is up for this one. So let's go ahead. You're doing a breath of fire and your eyes are 1/10 open, staring at the toes. Let's go.
Skydiver, that's okay too, but bend at the knees and grab your feet and grab the ankles. We're going to inhale, rise up, lifting up here, breath of fire. It's 1 minute. It can be a skydiver too.
but lift up as much as you can here. Breath of fire, thumping the navel in and out. Inhale, rise up even more. Squeeze, Mulabandha, hold it. Gazing out the third eye, you've got this. Now when you release, let the legs go down. I want you to put your hands on the earth. Push up. You're coming up on your knees. Last posture. Get the knees wide as you need. We're going into a camel. That can be right here. Can be all the way back. If you are, take it gentle and slow. You're opening yourself up, allowing yourself to open up to this world. A very vulnerable position, letting the head be back. Long, deep breathing. Breathing. Right now, stay in the posture. Give me 30 seconds of breath of fire to finish it up. Very carefully bring yourself up. Very carefully. It's a lot of energy. Make sure your cervical spine is okay. Raise the arms up. Inhale. Bow down. Let your hands touch. Let the butt rise. And then float yourself down into child's pose. You can stretch the arms out or grasp the soles of the feet behind you. Maybe do that. Let your third eye touch. Let your back body be receiving, completely receiving through the back body. Breathe. Om Namo, I bow. Wisdom above, to the wisdom within, the guru within, all of the potential of the darkness and the light, the equanimity, finding the balance to find the connection. Guru, darkness and light. Thank you.
Nice long, deep inhale. Hold the breath, squeeze Mula Bandha, light yourself up from the inside out. Release and start to rise up. Keep all of that energy. Try not to open the eyes. Just shift into easy pose, meditative posture. Let your hands come into a Gyan Mudra, totally open to receive. And I invite you to take the index finger and press down on the thumb today. That knowledge really just shifting out from the ego, being able to fully receive. I'm going to do the morning call. Ek Onkar Satnam Siri Wahe Guru. We inhale and it's Ek, and on Ek we pull Mula Bandha. Ong. Make sure you get your tongue to the roof of the mouth. Kar. Then we take another breath. You keep Mula Bandha locked. Come to your heart. Sat. And Nam. Opening up that throat chakra. Then we take a sniff. We still have Mula Bandha. And that's Siri for the third eye. Siri. Wahe Guru. And the energy, that darkness to light, that shifting open, comes out the crown. And on the Wahe Guru, you release all of the breath, the Bandha, and you visualize yourself just being showered with light. When we inhale, we are bringing in that prana, Ek, and we lock it in and we start to rise up through the chakras. Ong is your sacrum, Kar is your navel. Breathing again, Sat, Nam. Breathing again, a whiff, Siri, Wahe Guru. Creating our own field, generating, clearing, activating, whatever it is you need today. This is us finding our perfect flow through the energy centers. Listen the first round. Get ready. Thank you.
foot.
Okay.
Oh.
take a moment to breathe in and out, expanding your field, feeling the flow. Maybe take yourself through the chakras, root to the crown, crown to the root. Breathing through the energy centers, creating this field up and in, down and around. And tuning into your heart. Maybe your field needs to be tight and close today. Maybe you want to expand it out. Keep it strong and clear and vital and your own. Set the intention to meet all peoples, all experiences in your highest possible vibration, in your truth and your authenticity. Slide your hands up to your heart. Let's close. Honoring the self, honoring each other, sending our love and light out to the world and to those in need. Closing in our highest truth with our sat nams. Deep inhale, let's raise our prayers up. May all beings know peace. May all yoga practice contribute to the well-being of all. As we exhale, we bring our prayer through the chakras. Please join me. Peace to all, light to all, truth to all, and love to all. We bow down, giving thanks to Mother Earth and Father Sky, blessing you, blessing your prayers. Receive some of that light into your hearts while you're bowing down. Grateful for this time together. Grateful for this practice. Grateful for this breath. Grateful for this community. Let's rise up together and greet one another with a sat nam.